Sabay di, good morning everyone to all brethren in ARC Bangkok. I am thankful for this wonderful opportunity to share to you God's word. Thank you to your pastor, Pastor Escanlar, for inviting me, even though I'm just recording this video, but it is a joy to share to you God's message today, not just in not just to the brethren in ARC, but also those who are watching online. I believe there are many online attendees listening to God's very word. I would like also to grab this opportunity to thank you for praying for us in Laos. If you have the idea, we are actually today, first Sunday of September, we are celebrating our 7th year anniversary. And it's all because of God's grace that we are still existing and we are still serving God in this communist country. So I am Pastor Kong Nifras, and I would love to share to you our screen for our message today, for our preaching slides. So here it is. I hope you can see all our slide for today. Let me bring to you to our passage. I chose the passage Matthew chapter 16, verses 13 to 17 for our message, God's message for today. I entitled our preaching, Who is Jesus? Let me whisper a prayer. Heavenly Father, we ask for heavenly wisdom. Dear God, the Holy Spirit, guide us, illumine our minds, and give us spiritual insights that would be helpful as we continue to please you, as we continue to live on this earth, and as we continue to do your mission and ministry. Thank you for your word, and may you use this word to encourage and bless all of us. In Jesus' name, Amen. As I have mentioned, our passage is in Matthew chapter 16, verses 13 to 17. Allow me to read this. You can also see it in your slides. When Jesus came into the region of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, saying, "Who do men say that I, the Son of Man, am?" So they said, "Some say John the Baptist, some Elijah, and others Jeremiah, or one of the prophets." He said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter answered and said, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." Jesus answered and said to him, "Blessed are you, Simon Bar-Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father who is in heaven." I will start our message today with a quiz. Are you up for a quiz, brothers and sisters? Here is the question. Where was Jesus born? A. Bethlehem, Galilee. B. Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. C. Bethlehem, Ephrathah. Or D. Bethlehem, Carmarthenshire. I think, and you can answer later on. I will reveal the answer at the end of our message. The passage that we have read happened in Caesarea Philippi. Let me bring you there for a while. It is situated 25 miles or 40 kilometers north of the Sea of Galilee. It's in the north of Galilee. And it is at the base of Mount Hermon. Caesarea Philippi is the location of one of the largest springs feeding the Jordan River. This abundant water supply made the area very fertile and attractive for religious worship. In fact, there are a number of temples that were built in this city during the Hellenistic and Roman periods. Caesarea Philippi was known as Baal Hermon or Baal God in the Old Testament period. And this site was later named Panias, after the Greek god Pan, who was worshipped here. The spring emerged from the large cave, which became the center of pagan worship. Beginning in the 3rd century BC, they were doing sacrifices, they were doing sacrifices. They were casting sacrifices into the cave as offering for their god, Pan. In fact, Pan is a half man, half goat god of fright. That's why fright, panic. It is often depicted playing a flute. The city's modern name is Banias. Banias in Ara it is the Arabic form of Panias. An open-air sanctuary was built for Pan next to the source of water that exited the cave. Augustus Caesar later gave this city to Herod the Great, who in turn built a marble temple to Augustus. Adjacent to the sacred cave is a rocky escarpment with a series of yawn niches. Niches, it's like a carved from the rock niches. It is known that statues of the deity were placed in these niches by depictions on coins of the city. So sa mga nicho na yon ay may mga statue of gods and goddesses. One niche housed a sculpture of Echo, the mountain nymph, and Pan's consort. Another niche housed a statue of Pan's father, Hermes, son of Nymph Mania, Maia. Inscriptions in the niches mention those who gave large donations. So in this very setting, no, sa maraming mga gods and goddesses sa pali sa nakakarb sa rock. In this very setting, Jesus asked the disciples a very important question. A very important question. And the answer, mga kapatiran, the answer to this question, the answer every person gives to this question will determine his or her eternity. So ang ating mensahe po ngayong umaga is this. Your knowledge of and relationship to Jesus will determine your eternal destiny. Again, let me read to you our message for today. Your knowledge of and relationship to Jesus will determine your eternal destiny. Going to the passage, first we can find here the guess of the truth. So let's dive into the topic. Verse 14, if you can, Jesus asked his disciples a question in verse 13. Who do men say that I, the Son of Man, am? Tinanong niya ang kanyang mga disipulo, ano ba ang sabi ng mga tao patungkol sa akin? What people do think of me? How do men perceive me? And the answer of the disciples is found in verse 14. Some say John the Baptist, some Elijah, and others Jeremiah, or one of the prophets. Some say that Jesus was John the Baptist with his message of repentance. John the Baptist's message is repentance. Jesus was commonly mistaken to be John the Baptist. Pareho kasi sila ng mensahe. Actually, they are cousins and they may look the same as well. I don't know if they may look the same. Meron kasi akong cousin na we somewhat resemble. So they may look the same. They have the same message of repentance, but they are exactly different people. Okay, they are not the same, but they may be the same, but different. Same, but different. Jesus was also perceived as Elijah. Elijah was known for his bold, uncompromising stand for the word of God, even in the face of ruthless monarch. Remember King Ahab and Queen Jezebel. Remember the courageous Elijah in Mount Carmel. Elijah against the prophets of Baal. So add to that courage is the last two verses of the Old Testament promised the return of Elijah before the day of the Lord, Malachi chapter 4. Behold, I will send you Elijah the prophet before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord. That made people think of Jesus as Elijah. But some others see him as Jeremiah or one of the prophets. So these are the prevailing views about Jesus during that time. If we read in Matthew chapter 6, verse 14 to 16, let me read. Now King Herod heard of him, for his name had become well known. And he said, John the Baptist is risen from the dead, and therefore these powers are at work in him. Others said it is Elijah, and others said it is the prophet, or like one of the prophets. But when Herod heard, he said, this is John, whom I beheaded. He has been raised from the dead. King Herod thought of Jesus as John the Baptist. Brothers and sisters, these are good guesses, but wrong. These are close guesses, but erroneous. They are error. They may be similar, but very different. In an exam, sa test po, kung may test, they may say that a guess sometimes is better kung sa Ilonggo pa, kisa ang lagpat, sobra pa sa tanda. But with Jesus, we cannot play guesses. Please remember that. We need to know and be on the exact truth, or else our eternity will be at stake. So mga kapatiran, ang mensahe po natin ngayong araw is that your knowledge of and relationship to Jesus will determine your eternal destiny. Pangalawa po makita natin dito is the fact of the truth. After hearing what the people thought of him, binaling po ni Jesus ang kanyang tanong sa kanyang mga disipulo. He personalized the question. He asked his disciples to give their own view of his very person. Sino ba siya sa kanila? And Peter, without hesitation, replied on behalf of the 12. Usually, Peter is the spokesperson of the group. He said, ang sabi po niya sa verse 16, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. You are the Christ, the Son of the living God. In Mark 8:39, he said to them, but who do you say that I am? Peter answered and said to him, you are the Christ. Similar story. And in Luke 9:20, he said to them, but who do you say that I am? Peter answered and said, the Christ of God. Peter believed that Jesus was the Christ. Ano po ba ang ibig sabihin ng Christ? Christ comes from the Greek word Christos, meaning the anointed one. It was equivalent to the word Messiah, Messiah, meaning anointed. Alam naman natin in Genesis chapter 3, it appears to be the darkest part of human history when Adam and Eve sinned. But remember, there is a promise there shining bright, and that is Genesis 3. 15. It's the first promise of a Messiah. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your seed and her seed, he shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his heel. The promise of the Messiah, the seed of the woman who will defeat, will trample down the head of Satan, of the enemy. This is the very promise of the Messiah, of the Christ. And this promise has been repeated throughout the Old Testament. As we know, God is a promise keeper. Ano pong ginawa niya ng Diyos? Jesus. He sent Jesus to become the fulfillment of His promise. From His birth, to His lineage, to His life, to His death, and even to His resurrection and ascension, Jesus is the promised Messiah. Jesus is the Christ of God. And there's a lot more proof to this truth that Jesus is the Christ, Jesus is the Messiah. If you go to gotquestions.com, you check out, it was clear that they believed Jesus to be the Messiah. Pero kung tanungin mo ang gotquestions.com, why did many of the Jews miss this truth? Although it's very clear, but why did many Jews miss the truth? And it will give you this answer. The story of Joseph provides an interesting parallel story of Joseph in the Old Testament. Parallel to the Jews missing their Messiah. Joseph was sold into slavery by his brothers, and after many ups and downs, he was made prime minister of all of Egypt. When a famine hit both Egypt and Israel, Joseph's brothers traveled to Egypt to get food. I hope you are familiar with the story. And they met Joseph, but they did not recognize him. Their own brother standing right in front of them, yet they were oblivious. They did not recognize Joseph for a very simple reason. He did not look as they expected him to look. Joseph was dressed as an Egyptian. He spoke as an Egyptian. He lived as an Egyptian. The thought that he might be their long-lost brother never crossed their minds, because Joseph was a Hebrew shepherd, after all, not Egyptian royalty. So in similar way, most Jewish people did not and do not recognize Jesus as their Messiah. They were looking for an earthly king, not the ruler of spiritual kingdom. Many rabbis, in fact, interpret the suffering servant of Isaiah 53. We know of Isaiah 53, suffering servant. They interpret it as the Jewish people who have suffered at the hands of the world. But it's very clear. It's Jesus suffering, the Messiah suffering. Their blindness was so great that no amount of miracles made a difference. It was a good thing that the disciples believed in Jesus as the Messiah. And Peter made that great confession, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." Mga kapatiran, your knowledge of and relationship to Jesus will determine your eternal destiny. The source of the truth. In verse 17, it says, Jesus said, "Blessed are you, Simon Barjona, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father who is in heaven." Never had Jesus before taught Peter and his disciples the fullness of his identity. Hindi pa niya pinakilala ang kabuuan ng kanyang pagkatao, personality during this time. But God the Father opened Peter's eyes to the truthfulness of who Jesus was. God had opened Peter's heart to this deeper knowledge of Christ by faith. Spiritually speaking, alam po natin, no, spiritually speaking, people are blinded by the enemy. That is why they do not believe, why they cannot see the truth, even though it is clear. Please remember, it's because of the enemy, whose minds the God of this age has blinded, who do not believe, lest the light of the glorious gospel of the glory of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine unto them. It was the same Jesus who walked with them. Why did others embrace the truth and many others did not believe it, rejected it? John chapter 1, verse 11 and 12. He came to his own, and his own did not receive him. That's very sad. He walked with them, he showed them their miracles, but they chose to reject him. Verse 12 is an encouragement. But as many as received him, to them he gave the right to become the children of God, to those who believe in his name. Praise God, if you are here today and you believe in Jesus as the Messiah. Saan po ba galing ang ating pananampalataya? Is your faith from you or a gift from God? The act of you believing, is it from God or from yourself? Ephesians 2, 8 and 9 says, "For by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast." Acts 3:16, "And his name, through faith in his name, has made this man strong, whom you see and know." Yes, the faith which comes through him has given him this perfect soundness in the presence of you all. Has God granted you this blessed revelation already? Are you seeing this truth that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of the living God? We praise God for being the source of this truth. It was God who granted us the faith to believe in Jesus, our Messiah, and worked in our hearts to embrace Him as our Savior and Lord. Mga kapatiran, let us be in constant prayer that God will enlighten the minds and hearts of those who do not believe, because they are still blinded. Their minds are still darkened. We need to pray hard because it is their destiny which is at stake. Your relatives, your family, your friends who do not believe, pray for them. Your knowledge of and relationship to Jesus will determine your eternal destiny. Verse 20 says, "Then he commanded his disciples that they should tell no one that he was Jesus the Christ." Tell no one that I am Christ. Jesus' messianic mission cannot be understood without the cross, which the disciples did not understand yet. Sharing Jesus as the Messiah during this time will further their misunderstanding. Mas hindi nila maintindihan si Jesus. But when everything came to pass, matapos na ang pagpatapos sa cross, ano pong ginawa ni Jesus Christ? He commissioned his disciples to go and become my witnesses. Acts 1:8. "You shall receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses to me in Jerusalem, in Judea, Samaria, and unto the end of the earth." Mga kapatiran, Great Commission passage. "Go therefore and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things that I have commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the age." Just today also, I gave a testimony in the Missions Month celebration in the Philippines. And I shared to them that this very passage has been my anchor, the very promise of God here, which says, "I am with you even to the end of the age," has been hinahawakan kong promesa ng Diyos. as I stay in Lao. I am 8 years already in Lao, and by God's grace, the ministry here in Agape Center is 7 years already. Today is our celebration. First Sunday of September is our birthday, Agape's birthday. So before, Jesus said, don't tell anybody that I am the Christ. But when everything came to pass, napakos sa cross, it is finished, he told his disciples, go and be my witnesses to all the nations. Going back to the question, which is the correct answer? Which did you choose? Correct answer is found in Micah 5:2. So correct answer is letter C. But you, Bethlehem Ephratah, though you are little among the thousands of Judah, yet out of you shall come forth to me the one to be ruler in Israel. So you can answer this question if you know, if you have that correct knowledge of Jesus. But the real question is the more weightier question. Ang mas mabigat po na tanong is, who do you think I am? Ang tanong ni Jesus Christ sa kanyang mga disipulo ay tinatapon ko rin sa inyo. I am throwing this question to you. Who do you think I am? Jesus is. Who is Jesus to you? Is he one of the prophets? Muslims also believe that. Is he a good teacher? Buddhists also believe that Jesus is a good teacher. Hindus, Kaudai religion, believe this as well. Baha'i faith believes Jesus is the manifestation of God. Is he a small God or is he just a man? Mga kapatiran, are you still guessing on what you are hearing? Or are you embracing the truth being revealed by God the Father that Jesus is the Christ? He is the Son of the living God. Believing in Jesus as your Messiah includes believing in his claim that he is the way, the truth, and the life. He is the only way you could obtain righteousness before God. He is the only Savior of men. Make sure, mga kapatiran, make sure that Jesus is your Savior. Is he your Savior? Make sure that Jesus is your Messiah. Make sure that Jesus is your Lord. Your knowledge of and relationship to Jesus will determine your eternal destiny. Who is Jesus to you? Lord, I believe that the presence of everyone in this worship is a sign that they are interested in knowing you more. I know that the Holy Spirit is working in our hearts. I know that you, O God, is revealing the truth to us because you are the source of truth. And thank you that we have the opportunity to be confronted by the truth today. Nawa po ang inyong salita ay maging encouragement sa bawat isa. I pray that we will strive, give our effort to know you more, our Creator, our Savior, and our Lord. Because this knowledge will lead to loving you and to serving you. May you bless ARC Bangkok, every member, Pastor Iskandar and his family, and may you bless everyone who have heard of this message. Bless your word in our hearts, and thank you for this wonderful opportunity to bless your people. In Jesus' name, this is our prayer. Amen. Okay, thank you everyone, and God bless all of you.